How many ways are there to distribute 12 distinguishable objects into 6 distinguishable boxes so that 2 objects are placed in each box? So first, what we're going to do, we're going to use the product rule. The product rule is going to be using the combinations. The combinations, right? So first, what I mean by that is that for the first box, we will have 2 chosen from randomly from the 12 available. Right, so we know that the combination must be chosen from 12, and we're going to choose 2. Okay, so what this means is that it's going to be NCR, in which n is equal to 12 and R is equal to 2. Right, so NCR is going to be 12 choose 2. 12 combination 2. So now the product rule states that we will multiply the next combination, right, for the second box. For the second box, we have 12 left, right, because we already chose 2 for the first box. The second box will have 2 guys chosen, 2 objects chosen from 10, right, so it's going to be 10 choose 2. And then the third one will be the combination from the 8 choose 2, right, because there will be 8 available. And from the fourth box, there will be 6 choose 2, and finally from the last box, for the last box it's going to be, well actually that's not the last one, that's one before last, so it's going to be 4 choose 2, and then finally 2 choose 2. Okay, so the product rule makes sense because when you're talking about permutations, I know this is a combination, but combination comes from the permutation, right? The permutation is the ordering of selected objects, but in this case the combination makes sure there's no ordering, that there's simply a combination. Let's say two distinguishable objects, once they're chosen, you're not going to order them within the same box, right? So that's what the combination takes care of. So what this means is that we're going to have 12 factorial divided by the 2 factorial, and then also, so the 2 factorial is accounted for by this 2 that you see here, the r value. But also it has to be n minus r. Remember, n minus r factorial is going to be 12 minus 2 factorial. 12 minus 2 factorial multiplied by 10 factorial, this number, divided by the 2 factorial, and then the difference between 10 and 2 factorial, which is 8 factorial. Right? And then 8 factorial for the third box, divided by the 2 factorial, and the difference between 8 and 2, which is 6 factorial, times 6 factorial divided by 2 factorial, and then 6 minus 2, that's 4 factorial, multiplied by 4 factorial divided by 2 factorial, and the difference, which is 2, between 2 and 4 factorial, times the last factorial, 2 factorial, divided by the 2 factorial, the right number, divided by the difference, which is 0 factorial. And as you know, the 0 factorial is equal to 1. Okay, so as you can see, look what's going on here. We can actually cancel out the 10 factorial, the 8 factorial, the 6 factorials, the 4 factorials, the 2 factorials. So in the end, all we have left is 12 factorial divided by the 2 factorial, 2 factorial. How many 2's are there? Factorials. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Right? And the 0 factorial is equal to 0. So what does that mean? It means that essentially for each distinguishable object will take one spot, right, in any box that you choose. So that means that you essentially can choose 12 spaces, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, right? 12 can go for the first one, then 11, then 10, then 9, then 8, then 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. But this would be permutation, right? This, when multiplied, would allow you to order these, right? Ordering in each box will take place, but the bottom that you see here makes everything turn out to be a combination rather than a permutation, because you're also dividing for each box. You're having the division by 2 factorial because you're not going to order the first 2 in the first box. You're not going to order the second 2. You're not going to order the third 2. You're not going to order the fourth two in the fourth box. You're not going to order the fifth box two that you choose, right? You're not going to count distributing, let's say, the first object in the first box and then the second object, and then saying, but wait, there's another way. We can take the second object first and then place the first object. No, that's still one way, right? That's why these two factorials take care of that, right? It's not a permutation. This is a combination, right? So essentially, even though we started out with different factorials on the top, it actually makes sense that we have this result divided by basically 6 2 factorials, right? 2 factorial, 2 factorial, 2 factorial, 2 factorial, 2 factorial, and 2 factorial. They just make sure that in each box, in each of the 6 distinguishable boxes, you don't have ordering of the 2 distinguishable objects in them, right? So what this equals, 12 factorial, let's see what that is on the calculator. That's going to be 479,001,600 divided by 2 factorial raised to the 6th power. And 2 factorial is simply 2 times 1, which is equal to 2. Right, so 2, and there are how many 2? 6 of them, right? So it's raised to the 6th power. Right, so if you do that, and you divide it by the 2 to the 6th power, you will get 748,4400, right? So that's going to be 7,484,400 ways to distribute 12 distinguishable objects into 6 distinguishable boxes so that 2 objects are placed in each box. So I hope this was fun and helpful. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.